when you are preparing for interview, especially for RBI grade B, you study based on your profile and not based on this transcripts of previous interviews.
Hmm.
But जब मैंने transcripts देखे last year के, and when I look these questions like banking related questions, like they ask very depth in KYC and many deep questions in technical part, finance part. So I was a little worried at that time कि ये कैसे होगा इतने short period of time में.
Hi everyone, my name is Anuj Chindal. I welcome you to my channel. Today I have Kalpesh Wani, who has cleared RBI examination in his first attempt itself, RBI 2021. First of all, I would like to congratulate you, Kalpesh, on clearing the examination in your first attempt itself. I think it's a big achievement. Let's not beat around the bush and talk straight about what's important here. This is something that a lot of students, believe me, aspire to and are unable to do. So hats off to you. Very well done there. And can you please introduce yourself and talk about yourself, about your workex, about your education, so that the aspirants who are watching this are aware about it, and then we can talk about the examination itself.
Yes. Good evening, sir. And thank you so much for your kind words. And yes, it does feel good that you have cracked the one of the toughest exam of the country. So, regarding me, I come from Thane district in Maharashtra, and I completed BTech in Electrical Engineering from VJTI Mumbai in 2017. Thereafter, I worked in cybersecurity field with Wipro for 2 years, and then I started preparation for the competitive exams like UPSC and RBI Grade B.
Hmm.
And I could clear RBI Grade B in first attempt, and I'm also appearing for UPSC interview this year.
Okay, amazing. That
is my brief background.
So you are a very smart man, I should say that. And to give you a perspective, I was posted in Mulund for some time. I was in SBI before this. I stayed in Mulund for quite some time, and there was a market near Mulund. I don't remember the name. Jahan pe meri branch thi, it was a big commercial hub, big market.
Okay.
So I worked there for a while, and then I moved to other parts of Mumbai. So to Thane mana jata tha, it used to be an open area compared to Mumbai. यहाँ पे थोड़ा स्पेस ज्यादा मिलता है. ओके, नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू फेज वन एंड फेज टू. आई थिंक तुम यूपीएससी में भी यू आर डूइंग वेल, आरबीआई आल्सो यू हैव क्रैक्ड इट, सो यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड व्हाट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन, टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट. ओके, लेट अस स्टार्ट विद फेज वन. फेज वन में क्वांट रीजनिंग इंग्लिश और जीए, इसके लिए क्या क्या पढ़ा? इफ यूपीएससी हेल्प्ड, देन व्हाट सोर्सेज डिड यू यूज फॉर यूपीएससी आल्सो?
Yes. So for CSAT part, like quant reasoning and English, so UPSC preparation, and before that in graduation when I was applying for placement, so that aptitude test was there. So that background was enough for me. Like I could easily clear cutoff. And for general awareness, the UPSC requirement and RBI requirement is a bit different in this part. So RBI asks factual questions and more related to banking and economy. So for that I studied separately. So monthly magazines from different classes. I studied that for 3-4 months, and those were enough for me to clear the cutoff for phase one.
Okay, wonderful. So, आज हम लोग discuss कर रहे थे. I was having an interview with some other aspirants also who cleared. पर एक बड़ा अच्छा सा एक discussion start हुआ था, which was about phase one, quant reasoning, specially these two areas. तो हम लोग discuss कर रहे थे कि यार how do we divide our subjects into levels when it comes specially to quant and reasoning. So I remember I had a word with some of the students in the past 2-3 days, and ek jo trend chal raha hai, which is very wrong, but it is something that has started, is ki students kya karte hain, ek bar concept samajh liya, let's say time and work ka concept hai, I just watched some video, I understood that concept. Now the second level is to start practicing. राइट, उसके लिए आपको बुक चाहिए होगी या कोई नोट्स चाहिए होगी या ऑनलाइन कहीं से आप क्वेश्चंस निकालोगे एंड यू प्रैक्टिस. लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स व्हाट दे आर डूइंग इज दे हैव स्टार्टेड प्रैक्टिसिंग क्वेश्चंस बाय गोइंग ऑन यूट्यूब, कि यूट्यूब पे कोई उनको क्वेश्चन दे रहा है एंड देन दे आर पॉज कर दिया वीडियो को, सॉल्व किया एंड देन दे आर लुकिंग एट द आंसर, विच इज अ वेरी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग प्रोसेस एंड आई डोंट थिंक इट्स एन एफिशिएंट प्रोसेस. तो उस डिस्कशन से एक और डिस्कशन निकल के आया कि क्या लेवल्स होने चाहिए when you are preparing for quant and reasoning. So when you prepared for CSAT, for UPSC, or your examinations in your placements, you must have also subconsciously divided your prep into layers. So thinking about it a little bit, can you just specify ki kis sequence mein tayari ko tumne kiya tha when it comes to content reasoning specifically?
Yes, in RBI exam, this content reasoning part is very tough. Like it is at CAT level exam, this part. So preparation for this part should be taken seriously. And I don't know how effective is that video dekh rahe ho, tum pause karke solve kare. I don't know. But yes, basic tum dekh lo ki kis type ke questions aate hai. And uske behind concept samajh lo, wo kaise, us questions ko kaise approach karte hai. And other the tricks and tips for those questions. And section wise cutoff bhi hota hai isme. So instead of targeting all the questions, maybe agar jo weak hai is section mein, wo specific parts ya specific jaise time and work ho gaya ki hum bas usi questions ko zyada focus karenge aur hamara zyada time usme invest karenge actual exam mein bhi. So instead of attempting all the questions, you target the specific question and you get the marks.
Right.
Maybe that will help. So and about the layers and all, I don't feel I'm the right person to speak on that part.
Dekho, subconsciously, I'll tell you what you might have done. Just correct me if I'm wrong, because we are having a small discussion. I think kahin na kahin kuch nikalna chahiye. Let's say tumne koi concept padha, first time kahin na kahin to padha hoga, hai na? Uske baad thodi si practice kari, whether online or offline, books leke aaye, notes leke aaye, practice kari thode questions. Then you go on to mocks. Natural sequence hai na, ki sir mocks se practice karte hain. First sectional mocks, ki maine khali time and work ke 20 question uthaye, ya khali time speed distance ke 30 questions uthaye, timer lagaya, and then I'm checking what is my speed, how good I am, what is my accuracy, what is my speed, how is my time managed. Fir comprehensive mocks ke upar gaye ki acha ab yahan pe check karte hain ki time limit ke andar how am I performing, kya 30 mein se am I able to answer 15-20 questions to get a comfortable score in quant or not, right? Is that the subconscious sequence that you used, or did you add any other layer also here?
नहीं सर, आपने एज यू सेड इट इज परफेक्ट ओनली. और ड्यूरिंग माय प्लेसमेंट प्रिपरेशन मैंने ये किया था कि फर्स्ट यू डोंट थिंक अबाउट द टाइम लिमिट, फर्स्ट यू थिंक अबाउट हाउ यू कैन सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन, दैट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. एंड आफ्टर यू गेट दैट फील कि आई कैन सॉल्व दोस क्वेश्चंस नाउ, देन ओनली यू वरी अबाउट द टाइम. दैट वुड हेल्प सर.
परफेक्ट परफेक्ट. चलो लेट्स मूव अवे फ्रॉम फेज वन, लेट्स कम टू फेज टू. Objective and descriptive both. Of course, UPSC descriptive must have helped in some or the other way. How did you tackle the areas which are not overlapping with UPSC?
Yeah. So mainly in phase two, economic and social issues has connection with UPSC preparation. So that helped me there a lot. But related to finance and management, I had to study separately. So for management part, many syllabus ke points dekhe kya kya topics hai, and on internet I studied about it, and especially through YouTube videos, because you know you don't have to sit exclusively for that and study. You can watch the videos anytime while you are eating or while you are doing any other stuff. So that helped me to save my time. And for finance, yes, you have the topics, and if you are preparing for other exams like UPSC, then superficial ideas you have, but in-depth idea you don't have, which RBI requires from those topics, especially in objective part. So for those topics, you can again go to internet and study more about it, or other class material is there, you can study that will suffice.
Okay.
And for descriptive part, yes sir, UPSC preparation helped me a lot, and the few students like failed the typing problem here, typing issue, and they were not able to type 400 or 600 words within that time limit. But for me, since I had the IT experience, so I was used to with the typing and all, so I did not face that issue there.
Perfect, perfect. I think that's very nice. Ek aur question mere dimag mein aa raha hai, which is connected with UPSC and RBI preparation together. In fact, a lot of students since yesterday have asked this question for me to ask from the aspirants who have cleared the exam. How did you manage between these two preparations together? Because I think you are at the peak of your performance at this time, performing well in both the exams. Inshallah, nikaloge a UPSC ka exam bhi. तो कैसे, हाउ आर यू मैनेजिंग बिटवीन दीज टू?
तो ये जो कॉमन पार्ट है उसका तो कोई टेंशन नहीं है, बट जैसे मैंने बताया फेज वन में यू नीड टू प्रिपेयर फॉर जनरल अवेयरनेस पार्ट, सो दैट यू कैन टेक आउट सम टाइम फॉर दैट पार्ट। इन फेज टू ऑल्सो फर्स्ट पेपर का कोई इशू नहीं है, सेकेंड पेपर के लिए यू नीड टू स्टडी। एंड जैसे मैंने बताया यू कैन वॉच द यूट्यूब वीडियोज एनी टाइम, यू डोंट नीड टू सीक द एक्सक्लूसिव टाइम स्लॉट फॉर दिस इन योर प्रिपरेशन टाइम। तो वैसे यू कैन वर्क दैट, इट्स जस्ट दैट फॉर सॉल्विंग द मॉक टेस्ट यू नीड टू फाइंड द टाइम, सो That way you can manage both the exams, I feel.
Did you use a lot of reverse engineering wherein you used mocks to prepare for the exam?
Yes, sir. Especially in general awareness part. So there, when I was solving the exam, I used to solve on laptop online, and whenever I get the questions which is different, and I feel that I should remember this question or this answer, there I used to simply take this snapshot of the screen for that particular question. And so at the end, I had around hundreds of such snapshots, and I studied that, and I got it.
Perfect.
Got
Very nice.
it.
One more question that is coming to my mind is, again, going back to descriptive and objective, a lot of students are still asking, or last year, ye kafi confusion tha, should we benchmark or segregate the topics that we have in the syllabus into, okay, this is only for objective and this is only for descriptive? Or should we prepare comprehensively all the topics from both the perspectives?
I think it's better if you can study comprehensively, because anyway, if you have studied objective part, and then when you are writing the subjective answer, there if you are mentioning the numbers, statistics, or some reports, that reference if you are giving, then your answer looks more reliable rather
Yes.
than just some random answer if you are writing. So
Right.
that would help there if you study comprehensively. And also, if you read the budget or economic survey or any financial document properly, which you think that it would help you in writing subjective answers, but those will help you in solving objective parts, because whatever you study, you are going to face the different or unique kind of questions in actual exam. So in objective part, more than remembering, you need to learn how you can eliminate the other option or how you can guess the right answer. So that would help if you are studied comprehensively, in my opinion.
Yes, I think very well said. Now, coming to the interview and the final part, I think I'm just guessing कि साइबर सिक्योरिटी से शायद कहीं ना कहीं
यस
क्वेश्चन आया होगा, तो
यस
व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वर यू आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दैट एरिया?
यस एंड यस हियर आई वांट टू हाईलाइट दैट कि व्हेन यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर इंटरव्यू, स्पेशल फॉर आरबीआई ग्रेड बी, यू स्टडी बेस्ड ऑन योर प्रोफाइल एंड नॉट बेस्ड ऑन दिस ट्रांसक्रिप्ट ऑफ प्रीवियस इंटरव्यू। बट जब मैंने ट्रांसक्रिप्ट देखे लास्ट ईयर के, एंड व्हेन आई लुक दिस क्वेश्चंस लाइक बैंकिंग रिलेटेड क्वेश्चंस, लाइक दे आस्क वेरी डेप्थ इन केवाईसी एंड मेनी डीप क्वेश्चंस इन टेक्निकल पार्ट, फाइनेंस पार्ट। सो आई वाज लिटिल वरीड एट दैट टाइम कि ये कैसे होगा इतने शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम में। बट लेटर आई गॉट टू नो दैट दिस क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क ओनली टू दोज हु आर POs in banks or who have some background in finance, not to all the students or all the candidates. And same happened with me also. So major part of my interview went on my experience in Wipro in cybersecurity, because I am certified ethical hacker. So and I mentioned that in my biodata. So they asked me on that. Also in extracurricular during my college, I was a college club reporter in Maharashtra Times newspaper, and I have written news articles at that time. So they asked me questions on that part also. Now this is nothing related to RBI, this job or this part of my experience. But at the end, they want the managers and not the technical geeks or finance geeks, if I say so. So while you are preparing for interview, you considered all these things and prepare more on your profile. Yes, you have to prepare for RBI, but prepare for your profile also.
Very well said. I think I remember I had an interview with Jatin, who is in RBI, and he mentioned in the last interview that I had with him after he got selected, that 50 more than 50% of your interview is based upon your HR, which moves out of your biodata form. And if you're able to ace that, you will ace the entire interview. Doesn't matter if you're not so good at the technical part. I think that must have happened in your case also, because you have a lot in your kitty and you you know, showcased all that and you were able to justify all that, they must have given you very amazing marks. Okay. Before finishing, is there any small tip or anything that you would want to, explain or discuss or share with the students, which you think might add positively to their prep in the future?
Yes, sir. Three things I would like to share. First is, especially when you are going to interview or maybe before phase one or phase two also, if you get the time, read a few documents like functions and department of RBI, which is very important.
Hmm.
Second is the annual report or at least the summary, which is provided by you.
Hmm.
There is a budget and economic survey that is very important. Now in phase two, directly one question came from budget.
Hmm.
So these documents are very important. You need to study thoroughly all these documents. Second about the preparation strategy. So you asked me ki tumne kaise both the exams you manage. So sir, mera ek college friend hai, bahut acha friend hai. He was also preparing for UPSC and he also got into phase one phase two and hum saath mein the interview ke liye. So humne ek common Google document banaya tha and common like we had the set of questions, simple questions like why RBI is called as central bank and RBI related questions and also what we are getting in day-to-day newspapers. So we used to read that and whatever we get the information, new information, we used to put that into document. So that हमारे पास एक common document था and वो मेहनत हम दोनों की बच रही थी. So same kind of thing if other candidates can do, that would obviously help others also. And third thing, especially in interview, just remember that your attitude matters the most rather than your aptitude. So don't worry more about what you know or मुझे तो ये पता ही नहीं है ये क्या पूछा है ट्रांसक्रिप्ट में, rather than be confident and give your best, that would help.
I think you put it amazingly. These are probably the golden words that if the students are able to use, they will certainly be very successful in a very short span of time. Congratulations, all the best for your UPSC, and I'm very very certain ki UPSC bhi nikaloge and you will have a very 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 good experience in the bureaucracy in India. If not UPSC, RBI bhi tumko bahut acha exposure dega in the meantime. You're going to have a nice time. Yeah. Nice time. Okay. All the best. Take care. Have a nice day. Thanks a lot for coming online.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. All the best to other candidates.